This is News Conference Extra with Conan Nolan.
Good morning and welcome to News Conference Extra, a special segment of Today in LA Weekend. I'm Conan Nolan. It's a sign of some very troubled times we're in politically when this past week we saw an extraordinary resolution introduced in the House of Representatives. Not since the Civil War has there been an effort to expel a member of Congress, not because they've been convicted of a crime, that's happened since then, but because they were a clear and present physical threat to their fellow members of Congress. That resolution was against Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene, a QAnon conspiracy follower. CNN reports she had liked Facebook posts calling for the death of House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. She expressed belief that the Sandy Hook school shootings and the one at Stoneman Douglas High School in Florida were fake and involved actors. She also had a post where she argued the 2018 campfire in Northern California, which killed 85 people, was started by lasers from space by a nefarious group who wanted to clear out land for the California bullet train. The resolution to expel Greene from Congress was introduced by Congressman Jimmy Gomez of Los Angeles. He represents downtown Chavez Ravine and East LA. So, Congressman, thanks for taking the time. Why did you file this resolution?
I want to expel her from Congress. That's the point, because I do believe that she's a danger to other members. She can bring guns into her House office building. She's not supposed to bring them onto the floor, but the members of the Republican caucus have been doing that recently, and that's why we put metal detectors in place. But she's walking around the metal detectors. So there is a real fear that she's going to incite violence that she's already done on January 6th by saying that the election was stolen from Donald Trump. I believe she is dangerous, and she's going to incite her followers to maybe do something worse. So I'm deeply concerned about her being in Congress and having a platform to spread her lies and her conspiracy theories.
She has the option to go around the metal detector?
She shouldn't. That's why we're going to have to impose a fine on members who do that. I think it's going to be $5,000 for the first offense and $10,000 for every offense after that.
But she's gone around the metal detectors at the Capitol, and Capitol Police have allowed her to do that.
Yeah, correct. The Capitol Police don't really confront members of Congress that often unless they're posing a direct threat to themselves or to somebody else. She has just blown right by the metal detectors, setting them off. So we're deeply concerned about that. Listen, we saw the results of lies on January 6th. Five people died. One police officer who was struck in the head by a fire extinguisher. This is serious. And we want people to understand that some of these ideas might seem crazy, might seem even funny and ridiculous, but there's people out there that believe them.
What are other members of Congress saying? And have you heard from some of your Republican colleagues?
Other members are expressing support for the resolution. They're saying thank you for doing it. But there are also members who are concerned that some of the folks who follow QAnon, who are QAnon believers and conspiracy theorists, they're going to get targeted because if they co-sponsor or they vote for this resolution. There are Republicans who are also interested in the resolution but are also deeply concerned. People have to remember that on January 6th, this mob, these insurrectionists, these conspiracy theorists that have broke into the Capitol, they weren't just going after Nancy Pelosi. They were chanting, "Hang Mike Pence," because he wasn't going along trying to flip and overturn a democratically elected president. Think about it this way. There are members right now that are buying bulletproof vests. They're trying to figure out how to beef up their security at home and in the district.
So it takes a two-thirds vote to expel a member of Congress. That's highly unlikely in this case, in part because Bakersfield Congressman Kevin McCarthy, the House Republican leader, is a supporter of Congresswoman Greene. What's your assessment of Mr. McCarthy in this matter?
I think it's shameful. I think that he needs to take a harder stand against Marjorie Taylor Greene and the other conspiracy theorists in his caucus. He failed to do it so far. I think, but in the end, I think he does it just for political purposes. What does it fit his political ends? I'm not sure if you remember. I won a special election in 2017, and my swearing in was delayed for several weeks in order to negotiate a new cap and trade system. Kevin McCarthy attacked me and said maybe he shouldn't be in Congress because he's been delayed getting sworn in. He attacked me over that versus attacking her, believing in QAnon, saying that Parkland was staged, saying 9/11 was an inside job. He attacks me because I'm trying to pass climate change legislation, and he doesn't even take any step forward to hold her accountable. That should tell you a lot about where his priorities lie.
And finally, are you concerned about your own personal safety?
My staff is telling me on social media people are issuing death threats against me. I haven't seen anything yet or have heard anything yet that's actionable. But I'm going to take a lot of precautions, be very, very careful when I'm out in public. One thing about the pandemic, at least I get to wear a mask and wear a hat when I go out to make sure that I blend in a little bit. So, I'm concerned, but Congress has never been easy, and the stakes are too high for me to back down or for anybody else to back down.
It's very sobering. Congressman Jimmy Gomez, Democrat of Los Angeles. He represents downtown. Thanks very much for joining us.
Thank you so much.